to be part of this press meet, Mr. Walters and Mr. Kosalda. With these few words, I request and invite our director, Dr. Minishati Thomas, to give a brief presentation about today's event.
We wanted Chennai, Tamil Nadu and the national coverage for our events happening in Trichy. So we thought the best way is to organize a press conference in Trichy, because we do a lot of good things, but it is restricted, the coverage is restricted to Trichy. So we want the world to know what we are doing, and that is why primary reason we thought of doing this. And why we are doing it, we are doing something unique on Friday. So we thought we should announce it to the press here. We are doing something which is first among all the NIITs, first among centrally funded institutions. We have a tie-up with one of the industry majors, which we will be unveiling on 5th. So before going into that, I want to give a brief presentation about what is NIIT Trichy, why it is relevant, what is big about the project we are going to do on, we are going to inaugurate on Friday. So welcome to the press meet once again. So the outline is a quick glimpse of NIIT. We have developed our strategic plan for 5 years. So I'll be giving a glimpse of it, and the Siemens Center of Excellence in Manufacturing. And we are also launching a hardware hackathon on 5th. All this will happen on 5th October in Trichy. Now coming to NIIT Trichy, it was established in 1964 as REC, Regional Engineering College, Tiruchirappalli. We started PG autonomous programs in 79, then UG autonomous in 86. We celebrated our silver jubilee in 89. President Venkatraman was the chief guest. We became a deemed university in 2003, and in 2004 we started the conversion to NIIT, National Institute of Technology. And in 2007, by an act of parliament, we became NIIT, one of the NIITs, to old NIIT, which REC, which got transformed into NIIT. We celebrated our golden jubilee in 2014. President, Honorable President Pranab Mukherjee was the chief guest for the golden jubilee. We attract the best of the students and faculty. As you know, getting admission into NIIT Trichy is very, very difficult. We have 6,500 students as of now. 23% are girls. We attract high-ranking JEE main students. So we have excellent students from all over India. We have faculty with international exposure. We have flexible and industry-aligned curriculum. We are the first among the NIITs to start flexible curriculum. First to start MBA and MCA programs. Sustained engagement with local industry and industries around the world, BHEL, NLC, Dalmia Siemens, TNPL, L&T, TCS, now Siemens. We have long-standing relationships with industry. We have alumni-sponsored innovation labs in the campus, which are doing excellent job of innovation and entrepreneurship. And we are focused on sustainable development. As you know, Trichy is a manufacturing hub. We have 700 small and medium enterprises around. We support them wholeheartedly. And we have a lot of community initiatives. And we have won a lot of awards in community. We have an FM radio as well to serve the community. Why we are ranked the number one NIIT? We are the number one NIIT for the last 3 years. So we won an award excellence in employability. Our placement records are excellent, UG and PG. We are best in project governance. We have technical education quality improvement program 1 and 2. Now we are doing phase 3. We were adjudged best in governance, Best Industry Linked Institute 2015, FICCI Asocham Awards for social responsibility. We do a lot of social responsibility. Now this week we are having the AnnounceThe there, where we do a lot of programs. We won the FICCI University of the Year in 2017. And we won the Green Campus Award from Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board recently. We received the award from the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. And this year was good, 2018, we won many, many awards. This is our student president receiving the award from Honorable President of India. We won the Best Innovation Club in the country, competing with another 80 centrally funded institutions in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And all this make us the top NIT in the NIRF ranking. 3 years in continuation from the time NIRF started, 16, 17, 18, we have been the top ranked NIT. And 12th earlier, last 2 years, we are the 11th best technical institution in the country. And 31st in the overall ranking. And the icing on the cake is 2 days back, that is 1st October, we received the Swachh Campus 2018 award from Ministry of Human Resource Development. So we are doing extremely well in terms of many, many aspects. Now, what are our key strengths? The brand NIIT Trichy, the key strengths are academic excellence. As I said, we have flexible curriculum, recognition from NIIT Council, we have competent faculty and scholars. Washington Accord, before signing, we were the only government institution chosen for inspection. And NIIT people came, experts came and inspected our evaluation process. Research and innovation, we have quality publications in Web of Science and Scopus. Our publications per faculty is one of the best in India. We have a lot of innovation and entrepreneurship happening in the campus. We have industry collaboration and alumni in top positions in the field. Here you see Chandra, Mr. Chandrasekharan, chairman of Tata Sons, TCS chairman Rajesh Gobinathan, and Tata Steel chairman T.V. Narendran, all alumni of NIIT Trichy, and many, many more names. This was convocation where Mr. Murthy was our chief guest, and we gave an honorary doctorate to N. Chandra, who is the chair of Tata Sons. So we have a lot more illustrious alumni across the globe to support us. We have excellent campus placement, as I said earlier. Infrastructure, we are the largest NIT with 800 acre self-contained safe and green campus. We won 2 awards this year from Tamil Nadu government and from Ministry of HRD. We have state-of-the-art R&D infrastructure. And we have a lot of competencies in ICT, and we hosted IIM Trichy for 7 years. They moved up this year. Now we are hosting IIIT Tiruchirappalli in the same campus. I am the mentor director for the IIIT as well, and we have NABL accredited laboratories, etc. So with all this, we thought we are well equipped to move forward. So we started looking for a strategic plan, putting in place a strategic plan for the next 5 years. Moving on, we will extend it to 15 years, where we want to move into the top institutions in the world. And we have the capability, as I explained earlier. So right now what we have done is, we did last 1 year we worked, starting from last October 2017, where we did a conference with around 20 experts from all over India. We did deliberations on what are the qualities of world-class institutions. How can we, NIIT Trichy, become a world-class institution? So, and then we did series of workshops, inbound, outbound. We did SWOT analysis. We identified the areas where we are strong, where we should be expanding. And now we have come out with a strategic plan, which we are launching on Friday. The grant launch is the first 5 years, 2019 to 2024. The key features which we have identified is we will be doing revamping our teaching learning with many parameters. We will be revamping our research, and we will be doing much more collaboration in India and abroad with academia and industry. And we will be working for sustainability of the campus and our programs, because now funding and greening, everything is at stake. So we will be doing a lot of work emphasizing on sustainability, and of course everything will run with infrastructure development. So these five areas we will be focusing in our strategic plan. And what we are aiming to be is a multidisciplinary university. Research-driven teaching, regional to a global campus. We'll be attracting more students and faculty from abroad, and we are going in for international accreditation. Our programs are now accredited by NBA, but we are going in for international accreditation, and we will be focusing on innovation and entrepreneurship a little more, and contribution to the sustainable development goals, like clean water, clean energy, environment, etc., etc. And what we are aiming at the end of 5 years is, in the US Time Higher Education, last week they announced the 2019 rankings. We are found a place in the ranking. We are in the 800 to 1000 rank. We want to improve it to the top 500. We want to jump into the top 500 in the world. And in NIRF, right now we are 31. We want to jump into the top 20 in overall category. So this is the aim of our strategic plan, and our tagline will read, locally relevant, globally competitive. So this plan details will be launched by the minister on Friday. And as part of our strategic plan, we are focusing on centers of dynamic excellence, where we will be collaborating with industry. And the first such center also the minister will be inaugurating, which is the first code in manufacturing in association with Siemens. We will be inaugurating on 5th. And the Siemens Center of Excellence in Manufacturing will be an interdisciplinary knowledge center equipped with state-of-the-art tools and technologies, will serve as a technical knowledge resource for industry, a hub for technical skill development programs in coordination with universities and industry. It will catalyze industry-academia partnership. Now, this is the first center among all CFTIs by Siemens, and it's a 190 crore investment, where 90% of the investment is by Siemens, 10% from us. And these are some of the pictures. These are some of the labs, and the Siemens Center has 12 ultra-modern labs. Product design and validation lab, advanced manufacturing lab, test and optimization lab, CNC controller lab, CNC machines lab, robotics lab, Internet of Things lab, additive manufacturing, automation lab, electrical and energy savings lab, mechatronics lab, and process instrumentation lab. And all these labs will have state-of-the-art equipment used for actual real-time manufacturing, and it's all ready and tested. Our students have already started working on it, and this will be formally inaugurated on Friday by the Honorable Minister. Now the benefits are there are multiple stakeholders for the benefit from this center, including government, because government will have larger skilled and employable workforce and create industry friendly environment. Whereas for the industry around, they will have shorter employee enablement time because they will already be skilled, increase competitiveness. And current employees also we will be training, innovative projects with academia we will be doing. For our institute, we can promote cutting edge research and promising innovations. Already our students are working on new innovations with the lab facilities available. we have created 10 teams of faculty to work with students to come out with new innovations and products, and we will be refining our curriculum content to include these developments. We will attract better faculty because more faculty will come equipped with capabilities to use these labs, and we will be doing capacity building and networking with nearby institutes, and it is an opportunity for revenue generation for us. And faculty will have actually what is happening, knowledge of the real industry, engaging in consultancy, because we'll be doing consultancy with these labs. We will introduce new courses and training programs and improved standards of publication we will have. And students also, they will have a lot of innovative projects. We are launching our hardware hackathon along with this, and they will be employable, much more employable, especially the institutions nearby. And the expected outcomes of the center are enhanced industry-institute interaction, improved faculty competency and research. We'll have increased publications, patents, products and processes. We will have revenues for revenue generation, improved student employability. We will have a lot more startups and spin-off entrepreneurship. We will have skilled workforce, and this is a branding for the institute as such. So this is about the Siemens Center of Excellence. I have here Dr. Dureselvam, who initiated this project almost 2 years back, coordinating with Siemens, and he has worked so hard to make this a reality. So he will be giving you more details in English as well as in Tamil. And I have Dr. Arvind, who is part of Siemens implementation partner, who helped us implement the labs. So he will also be interacting with you. And I have Professor Bhaktavatsalam, who is heading the training and placement office of NIIT Trichy, and he was part of our strategic planning group. So he is also here to answer any other questions. I just want to conclude saying that we will be launching our hardware hackathon also on 5th. So this is to develop some product and prototype in 5 years by students from NIIT as well as from outside. So website release.
Thank you to the wonderful team at NIIT Tiruchi for the awesome support and setting up this lab. And I'm from AmmaTech. AmmaTech is an acronym for Advanced Manufacturing Automation and Robotics Technologies. We are based in Bangalore, and we are a solution partner for Siemens Industry Software, and we focus industries to come and utilize this center for research and consultancy. And we would also be regularly organizing industry workshops and academia workshop at the COE, and we would also enable NIIT to interact with industries utilizing our industry network, and we would also facilitate that.
So we have invested only 10%. We have a lot of pressure in getting back the money in terms of break even, and we are working hard to towards internal revenue generation. And apart from that, we have a lot of multifaceted objectives, like running the center for different for the benefit of different outcomes, like research and development, doing a lot of consultancy. And even though we have a 100% placement, when you look at the surrounding educational institutions, they still have a lot of problem employing their graduates. So we have an extensive skill development program that will be run in different laboratories. And the Siemens have identified some skill development courses. Those courses are carefully designed by their team after a thorough market analysis. And if a student goes through that course, and if he get a certification by Siemens and jointly certified by NIIT, the employment opportunity will be very high. And so far we have identified some 30 plus courses that will be run at different laboratories that varies between 10 hours to 150 hours. And these are some of the major things what we are planning. And we have a dynamic faculty team involving in operating the center and director madam identified for every laboratory. We have a lab coordinator and some faculty members also associated with that. We'll be working with the Siemens and Amartya team to bring the center to the limelight, and as madam have shown a lot of outcomes, and we wanted to align ourselves in the overall vision and mission of the institute. And that would be a definite help for boosting our ranking in NIR of another basis. Thank
you.
Sir, can you close out?
Sir, not close out.
Sir, excuse me.
We are presuming that government funding will continue, but in addition, we are banking on internal revenue generation by all this, like Siemens Center and many more centers. We'll be opening up our laboratories and our labs for consultancy, and also we are banking on alumni. We haven't tapped our alumni potential at all, so we have created a new office of alumni relations, and we will be we have got some investment for alumni already. We have two innovation labs in the campus, and we have one endowment worth 1 crore where the alumni wants us to bring Nobel laureates to the campus. So we are looking for more endowments, more chair professors, more involvement from alumni.
You are looking to raise funds, man, towards this?
Yes.
You have any numbers in your...
We will reveal it on 5th. But partly, like half government, rest we will be generating.
That recently, government of Madhya has come for the IOD status for several central institutes.
Yeah.
You think that your institute can get that IOD status?
Yes, we work very hard making our 50. So it was a good exercise for us. We could realize our strengths, weaknesses, and our opportunities. So we have a plan. IOE tag was just 1,000 crore more, but we hope with IOE or without it, we will move forward. Institutions, I'm sure they will consider us.
How will the institute?
We did a good presentation. So we hope if the government gives more, maybe they will consider us also.
Andhra, Gujarat, already they are running. And the similar courses and run பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க சக்சஸ்ஃபுல்லா. ஸோ தே ஹேவ் த கோர்ஸ் கண்டென்ட் உள்ள என்ன இருக்கு, என்னென்ன நடத்த போறாங்க, ஸ்டூடெண்ட்டுக்கு எந்த மாதிரி பேட்டர்ல அந்த டெஸ்ட் வைக்கணும், எல்லாமே இட் இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி தே ஹேவ் த பேஸ். இமீடியட்டா வி கேன் லான்ச்
30 கோர்சஸ்மே
லான்ச் பண்ணலாம் சார். ஸோ வி ஹேவ் 12 லேப்ஸ், அந்த 12 லேப்ஸ்ல அந்த கோர்சஸ் வி கேன் ரன். Placement, we are not directly involving, but definitely from the other center's experience, there is a definite boost in the employment. Later on, we will talk about it. Probably, Aravind will tell the details. We are linking the students, those who are going through the course, with one portal where the Siemens customers have already registered, by which we are bridging the customer with the suitable employers, and by which they could able to identify for some project internship, and if they are good, they can also take them as a employee. So the related portal, Mr. Arvind will give some explanation.
So it's a portal which is called SME Forest, with the SMEs, like Siemens customers, so where they can access the profiles of these students online, and they can assign them projects, as well as if required, they can hire them.
And the press and media people gather over here. Press and media people gather over here. And very good afternoon, all of you. And it is a pleasant moment to be with you in this afternoon. And first I wanted to thank our director, and who is always giving much importance to the branding and giving exposure to NIIT, which helps in many ways. What are the things that we are, what are the good things that we are, Professor Bhartavakshalam, who is behind that institute, the strategic plan team, and who has molded a very good plan for the futuristic activities of all our academic research in NIIT Tiruchi. I thank you, sir, for your presence here. And Mr. Arvind Chinnappa, who is with us for the past 3 years, and we are building the center with so much of care, and we have crossed a lot of critical threshold and the points. And now the center has come to stage to inaugurate by the Honorable Minister on Friday. And for him, I give a special thanks. And I thank the catalyst, PR and Media Service, Mr. Singaram, who has put a lot of effort in a short notice and bring quite a lot of press people to be present in this auspicious occasion. Thank you, sir, for your involvement in that. I thank all the present media, in spite of your busy schedule, to allocate time to spend with us. Thank you very much. I am also inviting you to alumni, two of our alumni who is here in this occasion. And I, on behalf of our director, invite you to be part of the inauguration of the Siemens Center of Excellence that is going to happen on 5th October. Thank you very much.
So thank you. We invite you for lunch. I invite you to the campus. As I said, we have an 800-acre campus, bigger than IIT Madras campus. So please come down sometime and see the campus yourself. Thank you.
Of NIIT Tiruchirappalli. On Friday, 5th October, we will be launching our 5-year strategic plan to take the institute into the top 500 in the world ranking. The strategic plan for 5 years will be released by the Honorable Minister for Human Resource Development, Government of India, Mr. Prakash Javadekar. As part of the strategic plan, we are inaugurating a Center of Dynamic Excellence in Manufacturing with the help of Siemens. Siemens has invested 90% of the 190 crore in this project, and this project has, this center has 12 labs with state-of-the-art equipment which will be used for research and development, as well as for consultancy, as well as for training industry personnel, as well as students from tier 2 and 3 institutions. And also we will be launching a hardware hackathon. These three events will happen on 5th October in NIIT Tiruchi campus. With this, we hope, right now we are 11th in, and at the national level as an engineering institute, we want to break into top 10 in the next coming years and in the top 500 in the world. Thank you so much.
What is the major benefits going to happen for the overall with these Siemens coming into the...
With the Siemens Center, the first thing is we will move ahead in research and development, in innovation, in prototyping, in developing new products. Second is we will be doing a lot of consultancy which will help the industries around, and also that will help us generate income for the institute. Third is we will be doing a lot of skill development for the employees of companies around, and also for engineering students, which will make them more employable.